India's diagnostic space is undergoing a transformation. Organized players are slowly taking over the business from local pathological labs, and that's where Dr. Lal Path Labs comes in. One of the oldest brands in India, the company has now drawn up an aggressive growth plan outside its base in North India. Joining us right now to talk about the growth plan and the possible challenges is Ved Prakash Goyal. He's the Chief Financial Officer at Dr. Lal Path Labs. Mr. Goyal, thanks very much for taking out the time. First off, let's just start off with how the quarter gone by has been. It looked like core Delhi and NCR markets slowed a bit for you.
Yeah, good morning. You're right. This time Q3, the growth is 12.1%. However, the Delhi has grew only 2%, and this is because of harsh winter, and December was the coldest this time. So this harsh winter, prolonged winter has impacted this time, this quarter. But the good part is rest of India, which is larger pie, which is 60% of our revenue, is growing much faster, which is 19-20% of growth this quarter.
Okay, let's talk about price increases. Did you take one in the quarter? And did that affect realizations per patient?
So price increase, for quite some time we have not taken any price increase. Last quarter in July, July last year, we took some increase in few tests. But we have done some correction as well. So the growth is coming from the overall volume. If you see, the realization per patient is 688 rupees as compared to 683 last year same quarter. It's slightly higher, the impact of some pricing, but it is the impact of mix as well.
Okay, so let's also get in a sense as to what lies ahead with regards to growth coming from Swasthya Fit. I think this time around it's been growing steadily at about 30% year on year. Is that the run rate for Swasthya Fit? And also, do you see it contributing more to the revenue going forward from the current 15% revenue share that it has?
I'm not able to hear you. Can you repeat your question?
I was asking you about Swasthya Fit. Do you see it growing at the current rate of 30% year on year that it has been clocking in, and therefore do you see it increasing the contribution to the revenues from the current 15% that it is doing?
Yeah. So Swasthya Fit is 15% of overall revenue, the contribution from Swasthya Fit, and it is growing more than 30% quarter on quarter. It's in fact helping us, where while one side, rest of India, where realization is lower as compared to Delhi NCR, why we are able to maintain our realization per patient is because of Swasthya Fit, where the realization is higher. And Swasthya Fit, where we are providing some common test in a bundled package at a discounted rate. For patient, it is value for money. For company as well, it is making sense for me, because I am servicing the same patient and my servicing cost is 2/3. So it's helping me, even if I am providing some extra test to the same patient at a discounted rate, it is not costing much or more to me. But while I am servicing the same patient, it makes sense to me, which is twofold, where I am maintaining my realization per patient, plus I am retaining the customer as well.
Okay, got that. So this was about quarter three. Let's talk about future plans at Dr. Lal Path Labs. What is the key focal area for the management? I believe network expansion is something that you're really focusing on. You want to widen your test menu. You want to diversify geographically to the west and southern parts of India. What kind of steps are you taking to achieve all of this?
It's a good question. In fact, if you see, while our core market north and east is growing, but our disproportionate focus is now on south and west, particularly on west. and we are very aggressive in terms of opening our network through collection centers, opening some of the labs at strategic points. And particularly Maharashtra, if you see, we are growing organically while opening a lot of infrastructure and making our presence there. Another way, if you see, we did some acquisitions. We did 5 acquisitions in last 9 months, and all are in West. And particularly recent 2 acquisition of Sangli and Yavatmal, they are in Maharashtra. So clearly now our focus is on West, particularly on Maharashtra now, and our disproportionate time and focus is going on this.
Okay, so how much of market share growth do you expect in these areas that you're focusing on? And then if you have to compare it to Delhi and NCR, which has grown at 2%, when do you expect that to normalize?
See, again, West as a whole is growing much faster than the company average growth. I told rest of India is growing about 20% this quarter, and it is consistently growing in this range, 19-20%. West, our idea or focus is to grow in the same range, which is 19-20%, maybe more. Delhi NCR, I have told you that this has impacted due to harsh winter, and the winter is still continue. That's the reason this time Delhi has impacted much more than what rest of India is.
Okay, so it will come back to its 7-8% growth rate post winters, according to you.
See, it's early to comment on that because we are still facing this winter in north, especially in Delhi NCR. Let's wait for February and end of March. We are able to see how Delhi is, but definitely there is a pressure on Delhi, which is our core market. Having said that, we are doing more focus on rest of India, and yes, that's where we are not totally depending on Delhi NCR. Rest of India is more, which is 60%, 61% of our all revenue, which is growing faster.
Okay, so will the rest of India also be a key contributor to your ability to maintaining your EBITDA margins at 25% plus?
So our EBITDA, normalized EBITDA margin is about 26.8% this YTD. This quarter is 24.4%. While margin in Delhi NCR is higher as compared to rest of India, directionally, if you see, when the volumes tend to picks up, then the margins are, we are getting leverage and optimization of our overheads, and that's where, even if you see this Delhi has grew only 2%, we are able to maintain our margins. So optimization and leverage, which is coming from our existing overheads, is where I do believe that going forward also we are able to maintain our margins.